Several weeks ago, I needed to install a new Raspberry Pi image on my Raspberry Pi here. And for the first time, I was actually going to use a graphical interface. So instead of just needing a USB keyboard, like what I have sitting over there, I needed a USB mouse as well. And I did not have one, or at least I thought I didn't have one. And actually, the whole thing is kind of pointless because I had a touchscreen that I could that it was plugged into. I just clicked on the touchscreen and it all worked. But that didn't stop me from borrowing Brendan's mouse before I found this out. Well, actually, it was Brendan's only mouse, and Brendan had to use the Control-Shift-Numlock trick in Linux to use his computer. This whole thing is actually kind of pointless because I already had a mouse right back there, and I had a few more downstairs, but I guess I just didn't notice or something. Well, at any rate, I decided this is stupid. I don't want to wait time for a mouse to come in the mail. So I decided I would make an ESP8266 talk or pretend to be a mouse and keyboard. How hard could it be? How hard could it be, you ask? How hard could it be to turn this thing right here into a USB mouse? Well, considering the chip itself doesn't support USB at all, and even Espressif saying that they're not going to support it on the ESP32, should be impossible. So it shouldn't be possible to turn that into a USB, mouse or anything. Except for the fact that I did. Or, more importantly, we did. This here is an ESP8285 board. ESP8285 is basically just an ESP8266 with the flash built in. At any rate, so this board right here has an ESP8285 on it, along with some minimal complement of components and a bunch of programming wires. These don't actually need to be here, they can all be desoldered. And this emulates a mouse and keyboard. So, first of all, when I say we did, I mean, this has really been a group effort. And I really want to thank everybody for coming out to the live channel. I really want to thank Espressif. They've been so helpful. Even though my goal was to make this a full-speed USB device, it turns out that's not possible for, well, a series of reasons. At any rate, let's get this thing plugged in and see what happens. So, I'm going to go now. I'm going to plug it into my laptop here. Make sure that it enumerates, and it does. I actually see right here it does list the ESP8285 as both a mouse and a keyboard. Mouse, keyboard. So with my smartphone here, I'm going to say connect to the ESP. It's connected. Now I can open up Chrome. It's going to visit the web page that's running from the ESP down here. And on this web page, I have a couple of things. I have a fake keyboard and I have a fake mouse. So this big green area allows me to control the mouse. So I can, I can select areas. I can just click. I can do whatever you do with a normal mouse. Right click, check that out. Whee! It's like a fake mouse and fake keyboard. Keyboard, because I can come into this window here, I can say show keyboard. Then, using my phone's keyboard, I can say LS or DMESG. And that will show everything that's in my kernel log there. And so with this, I can, execute special commands too. So Alt F2 brings open a run dialog. I can type in Firefox, and I can just press go to press enter. And I can, whatever I'd really need to do here. So I can just go up there, double click, and let's visit Google, let's open up a new tab, Control T, hack, I don't want that, uncontrol, I am not very good with my phone, hackaday.com, go, boom, there is Hackaday. So this is my little ESP8266, ESP8285 mouse and keyboard thing. And I really do need to give credit to everybody in the community because things like how the mouse interacts here, That's not my code. How any of the stuff at the ESP is really, it's just so much of the community. Everybody's really come together. Especially this guy, Confuse, from GitHub. He's just taken all of these projects and started to unify everything to make it all work a lot better. So I wanted to say thank you to the community, thank you to Espressif, thank you to, well, just everybody. And even though full speed on the ESP is kind of out of the question, there's a lot you can do with low-speed USB devices. All of this code is available on GitHub under ESP-USB and the newly created library ESP82XX. Links are in the description. One of the coolest things about this entire project is now there's two new options. Now, these are probably going to change, and the way the bootloader works is probably not going to remain the way it is. But as it is, I can type in make USB burn. And this will actually connect to the ESP. Actually makes sense to close the, let's try that again. There we go. Now it's flashing the ESP from the USB. And it's verifying and reflashing it now. The burn. If I run that, let's try that again.